Hello, everybody. Andrea Twarowski with Dentalelle Tutoring. Just a quick little side note. Sorry for the mess behind me. We had just moved, so things are a little bit crazy. So I've been tutoring now for about 13 years. I've been in the dental profession for about 13 years as well. I started off as a dental assistant, then I became a dental hygienist, and then a restorative hygienist after that. And now I work from home primarily tutoring for the dental assisting and the dental hygiene board exam. And I work about twice a week in Kitchener. So I work at a dental office about twice a week and I love it. But primarily I do tutor from home because this is my true passion, is just basically teaching people and helping you guys understand all about your oral health. So speaking of which, I am going to talk about night guards today. Now I wish I had a sample for you guys, but it's been a couple weeks since I worked at the dental office because we moved, so I did take some time off, so I don't have any samples with me. But you might be wondering, so at your last appointment, you might have been told that you need a night guard, or, sorry guys, something just popped up here. You might have been told that you need a night guard, or you might have been told that there's evidence of you clenching and grinding at night. So let's talk about that. So honestly, 99% of people out there will need a night guard at some point in your life. I have seen patients as early as the age of 14 who I have said, I think you need a night guard. It's very, very common. You know, I see it a lot in college students, university students, where they are so stressed out that they're clenching and grinding their teeth either during the day or more typically at night. So they're doing, you know, this, and they're like clenching. Now, your teeth handle a lot, and you clenching and or grinding, that's a lot of pounds of pressure, and your enamel simply can't handle that. So if you're doing that every single day, your enamel starts to wear down, where it's very, very thin and starts to wear down. And enamel, you can't grow enamel back. So once enamel wears away, you can't do anything about it. So it's very important to get a night guard so that if you are clenching at night or even during the day, you're clenching your night guard and not your enamel. So does that make sense? And the nice thing is too, that if you have sensitive teeth now, it's probably from clenching or grinding. So once you wear a night guard, your sensitivity should go away. I know that this is what happened to my fiance, Tom. He had very, very sensitive teeth, but it's because he was clenching at night for, you know, years. And until he met me, he didn't know what he was doing, right? Like, he didn't know that. So once he got a night guard, he had no sensitivity at all. It completely helped him. Plus, if you're the type of person who wakes up with a headache or a migraine, it could be because you are clenching at night. So if this happens to a lot, talk to your dental hygienist about a night guard, because it will be like night and day. Like, you will just be so happy. Now to talk about that too, it is a little bit tricky for some people to get used to them, because you're wearing something in your mouth. So I've had patients tell me that they tried to wear it the first night. It's too, you know, uncomfortable for them, so they take it out. They try again the next night. They start to get used to it, okay, but it's still not perfect, so they end up taking it out. But then by the third night or by the week afterwards, they go, okay, it's not so bad. Like, I'm starting to get used to it. And I do tell patients that when you are at home, to just sort of help you get used to it, put it in around the house. So if you're just planning to stay home anyway, just put in the night guard, and then that will help you get used to it, because it will help you so much. If you need a night guard, you need a night guard. Like, you will not be sad that you have a night guard. Yes, it's not the most attractive thing ever, but who cares? If you need one, you need one. Okay, trust me. And what else did I want to mention about night guards? Oh yes, for a lot of the night guards out there, you do have to put it in a bowl of warm water. Not so hot that the water hurts you, but put the bowl, put the night guard in a bowl of warm water for a good minute or two, because that will help to soften up the night guard and make it more pliable so you're able to put it in. If your night guard needs that warm water and you try to put it in without doing that, your night guard will not fit and it will be uncomfortable. So if you're having troubles with your night guard now, it's probably because you have the type of night guard where you do have to put it in a bowl of warm water for a good minute or two, and then you put it in the mouth, and then it just sort of helps to mold even more to your teeth. And you could have a night guard for either the top teeth or the bottom teeth, but it's typically for the top teeth. And that's because your mandible, it obviously moves, if that makes sense. You know, if you watch me talking, my top teeth do not move. The bottom ones move up and down, side to side, right? So if you have one for the bottom, typically they don't work as well, because if you have one for the top, as you're going to sleep, it just sort of helps to keep your jaw in a more relaxed position, if that makes sense. So that if you are clenching and grinding, it's not as much because it's in a more relaxed position. And B, if you are clenching or grinding, you are doing it to the night guard and not your enamel. Another thing to mention, if you are told to wear a night guard, wear it every night. If you wear it every other night, if you wear it once a week, it's not going to work as well for you. You will have to wear it every single night. And once you get used to it, you guys, it's so easy and your teeth will not be sore and you are actually saving your enamel. I wish I could show you guys some pictures of what happens if you're not wearing a night guard and how the enamel starts to wear down. In fact, I will find some pictures for you guys and I will put that in my next video, because that's a good idea. Because if you have no idea what I'm talking about, then you might be like, what's the big deal, right? No, you need a night guard. So please, if you are told to wear one, you need a night guard. And if you have insurance, typically a night guard is covered, but not all insurance is covered. So please check. Even if you don't have insurance, it is worth it. So please save up the money. Do what you have to do to buy that night guard. Okay. And a night guard, I should mention, you can only get a proper night guard through your dental office, because they need to take custom impressions of your top teeth and the bottom teeth. Do not buy the night guards from the store, because they're not custom. They will either be too large, too small, and the material is nothing special. You could actually do more damage than good. So spend the money and get a custom night guard from your dental office. Okay, trust me on this. Trust me. Okay, if you guys have questions, let me know. I am so happy to help, and I'll see you guys in the next video.